Welcome to part 8 of the Behaviour Change video tutorial series, accompanied by the Juice Mail blog, which you can go and look out for on the biomechanicseducation.com website. So we've got tools, we've got things going on, we've got our goals in place, we've got our mindset pieces there. So what we're looking at now, we've got this motivation, but now what? Well, now what we've got to do is start researching. We've got to look at education, research, and also our resources. So this particular video is to help you understand how important it is when you get going, you've really got to have the right information in place. If we do this right and we do it well, then our clients are more likely to stay motivated, hit their goals, and we feel more successful. So what this means is getting yourself fully immersed into the subject in all the platforms where you can access education, research, and resources. So what is education exactly? Well, if you look in the Oxford Dictionary, it describes it as a process of receiving or giving systematic instruction, especially at school or university, a course of education, or an enlightening experience. So if you know me, education has gone from my hatred to my complete passion, having found a way of being able to get myself educated after having not great experiences at school and being farmed off as a non-academic. So education that really has an impact also has a point of reference for the individual receiving the information. It's no good being a lecturer or just passing on information if there's no relevance to the listener or the learner. We have to give them a point of reference. And the other thing to be mindful in terms of our clients is we've got to make it resonate with them and their world. We all see the world in different ways based on our life, experiences, and the way we see things. So we've got to try and be empathetic to the receiver or our client in the way we pass on this education. Now, when it comes to our clients, what we've got to look at is where our information is coming from. And obviously, we get our education on courses, but there are a lot of other mediums that are influencing what we perceive or what we hold in our mind. And we've got to help our clients understand that it may not be as scary or as intimidating as they've been led to believe. So part of behaviour change is education, educating our clients, ourselves, but also we've got to do some research. Now the research part gets quite interesting, because when you do start to research on the internet, through books, through magazines, newspapers, going to courses or events, what you can realise is that quite often we're being influenced by big, heavy hitters who are multi-million pound, billion pound companies that are influencing us deliberately to believe or think in a certain way. So what we have to try and do for ourselves and our clients is understand what information is accurate and what is potentially misleading us or giving us an impression of something that may not be quite technically accurate. Now, I know you know what I'm talking about if I mention it in terms of politicians. You know, how many politicians do we trust their word? They're trying to influence our choices. This is the same as these big marketers. You go into supermarkets and you are being influenced very, very specifically based on tons of research they've done on the way we respond to certain colours, languages, text, fonts, sizes, placements, and descriptions of, my mouth's watering now thinking of the supermarket, it's about lunchtime. So we've got to watch out and make sure that the information, the data, the research we gather comes from a relevant, valid, reliable resource. So there are great resources out there and there can be some really misleading ones. So what we've got to try and do is look at where the resource or the information is coming from. So we can look at the websites, we can follow through to the articles and maybe do a little bit of research into who's written it, who are they, where's it come from, who paid for the research is a big one for particularly with the food sources, things like that. And so that we can understand better where this information has come from. So the more you do research, the more you gather data, the more you look into and immerse yourself into the information that you're looking for yourself and therefore to help your client with behaviour changes, the more confident you'll get. Common sense kicks in and we can start to pick and choose and piecemeal the information we're actually going to use. But we've got to really make this relevant in it, to the client and their goal as well. So we've got to look back over the information we've gathered from them. And then the key part is put it into practice, take action, gather this data, put it together, maybe create a resource for your client, a handout with exercises on or information on, so that they've got something to go away with and think about. You might even point them in the direction of videos or articles or blogs or books or TV programs, documentaries that you have found helpful that you think might help them too. Great, so next time we're going to be talking about paradigm shifting and context, really, really key in our industry. So watch out for those in part 9. As always, my name is Rachel France. I can be found at biomechanicseducation.com, on social media, Facebook, Instagram. Do let me know how this is helping. If it's helping, maybe it's not helping, or if you have any questions, and I look forward to hearing from you.